get one, because he is a really good player, and you know, he's put up 8 top 3 finishes, and not one. That's impressive. I mean, well, you know, that's really being close.
But you're born at the wrong time, and you had to compete during the Tiger Woods era. I mean, there's 14 of them right there. Someone else wasn't going to win. It's not like there are 20 majors a year. There's 4. I mean, because of the Tiger's dominance during this era, there are a lot of guys that either don't have any, or maybe just have one.
Yeah.
And Westwood is 40 years old. He's played his whole career in the Tiger Woods era. Well, there's 14 majors right there off the books.
Also, there's a lot of them that have been won by guys that aren't very good, to be honest with you. I mean, there's a lot of the guys that have been won come out of nowhere, you know?
Well, this is a little bit about my point about how the top 10 and the top of the game has gotten stronger. And I don't want to say getting away from DJ, who won 3, or before yesterday, Mickelson, who had 4, but it took Phil until he was 34 years old before he won his first major. You know, Patrick Harrington won majors, but not one more during, you know, Tiger's time that he's away from the game. But there was a stretch there during Tiger's, you know, he had a 7 out of 11 stretch of winning majors and all that, where it seemed like the top 10 guys couldn't hang with Tiger on the weekend. If they would get paired with him or they were in the mix with him, they crumbled. But in most cases, not all of them. So what happened was he caught guys who suddenly found magic for 1 week. A Sean McKeel, a Rich Beam, a Ben Curtis, a Todd Hamilton. It was like if Tiger wasn't winning it, you were more apt to go outside of like the top 100 to find a guy who thought, wow, I got the lottery this week and I'm fearless and I don't care. I'm just going to go for broke because I may never get this chance again. They were more likely to win it. Well, we're not seeing those now. We're not seeing those situations unfold. We're seeing guys at the top of the game, the upper echelon, is dominating the biggest events.
Yeah, and we've seen 3 straight guys in their 40s win in the British Open, which is interesting in its own right. Real quick before we go, who does the course in Rochester favor?
Well, we were there 10 years ago for the PGA Championship. We had the Corgis Leaderboard. I've never seen it. One of our biggest events. We had the last 4 guys standing at Oak Hill were guys that had really basically never done anything. And I'm not trying to discredit them, but our last 4 guys there at Oak Hill and the PGA Championship were Sean McKeel, Chad Campbell, Alex Cheka, and Tim Clark. At that time, I mean, it was like, is this a major championship or, you know, the Southern Farms Guaranteed Classic just break out the John Deere Classic? I mean, what is this? This major championship, you know, on all the rest. Tiger, Phil, yeah, they were all there. They did nothing. And the rough was so thick and high. And the course reminds me, you know, it's had tremendous history there. I love the place. It's had Ryder Cups, PGAs, U.S. Open. It looks like, to me, when you pull up, even right down to the clubhouse, it looks like Wingfoot. I mean, it just feels like Wingfoot to me. And you think about some of the great classic, really tough, fight to the finish major championships we've had at Wingfoot. That's what Oak Hill looks like. It's sometimes, to me, it's going to feel more like a U.S. Open than a PGA championship.
So it's going to be a hard scoring course again.
It should be another one, although the PGA has a guy that sets up their courses named Kerry Hayes, who believes in excitement and believes in what gives the guys a chance to make birdies. They're not trying to protect par like some, you know, like some of the other ones, like the U.S. Open. So they'll try to make it. I think they'll try to ease it up a little bit. I'm not predicting this will be one of those events where even par wins it or 1 or 2 under, but it's going to be tough. I can't wait to see. It's been a phenomenal year. You think about the 3 major champions. That's pretty good. Pretty good triple so far. Adam Scott, Justin Rose, Phil Mickelson.
No, it's been a good year. It's been a lot of fun, and that just changed dramatically with Phil because, you know, this year didn't start off looking like it was going to be great for him, but since the U.S. Open, it has been terrific, and you're still going to have the Tigers storyline going into the PGA. Now you got Phil coming off a win. You got Adam Scott, who's been close now a couple of times and won one. So it's going to make for a good couple of weeks, no question. The PGA sometimes get lost. This year, I think there's a lot to this, you know, a lot to the PGA Championship this year. I think it's going to turn out to be a very good tournament.
I actually think the PGA stature has really risen for about 20 years, and as because of Tiger. Tiger refocused the world on how important the majors are. And he's cursed him now later in his career because he was the one who defined how his career was going to be measured in the end. It was going to be measured by majors. And he put such an emphasis on it that the four events became bigger than ever. And the PGA now has taken on this aura of, it's your last chance. It didn't used to feel like that, and it felt like, I'm talking a generation ago, kind of like an afterthought to start. But now, it's been in many years the best major of the year. And there is an urgency to it. I've seen it transform in our years of doing this tournament. We have nothing to do with that, by the way. Again, I think it has to do with the emphasis that the players, and specifically one player, the best player, put on it. That if we don't win here, I've got to wait 8 months until the next one. Sure, I've got to go play in the FedEx Cup playoffs and the Ryder Cup or President's Cup, but I've got to wait 8 months to make my mark in major championship golf, and there is an urgency.
I agree.
You know, I can actually remember 20-something years ago, I ran into one of the top players in the world at the PGA, Bell Reeve, St. Louis, and it was Ian Woosnam. And I saw him at dinner on Wednesday night. It happened to be in the same restaurant in St. Louis. He had come from a vacation with his family in the Caribbean. And I asked him how much he prepared for the PGA. Now, mind you, he had won the Masters a couple years before that. And he was coming to St. Louis from a family vacation. And he said one day, he golfed and to go out and hit the ball. So he went to like a little 9-hole golf course on whatever island it was in the Caribbean and rented a set of clubs and bought 3 golf balls out of a jar where you paid cash at, you know, the cash register. There were some old reused golf balls, and he bought 3 old used balls and went out with a rental set of clubs and played 9 holes of golf. Now, I've never told that story before. We had a good chuckle about it, and you know, at the time I thought, that's pretty amazing. They didn't know who he was. He was walking in, he's one of the top players in the world, former number one, and he just goes to some public course on an island in the Caribbean and buys 3 used golf balls. That's how he prepared for the PGA.
Well, it's changed,
you
as
know?
You said.
Then you wouldn't hear that today.
No, and I agree.
You'd never hear about that today.
I agree, and with Phil winning yesterday, it makes it that much more interesting. Thanks, Jimmy. We'll chat soon. I appreciate
Thanks,
it very much. Thank you, Jim Nance. We'll come back. We'll open up your phones right after this.
Decidedly odd back to baseball weekend. Brandon Phillips, the Cincinnati Reds' 5-second baseman, was quoted in Cincinnati Magazine as saying the 6-year, $72 million contract he received from the Reds was a quote flatter. Because Joey Votto, the Reds' star first baseman, received considerably more. Wow. Eric Bedard, the Houston Astros off-injured pitcher, asked out of a game Saturday while pitching a no-hitter in the 7th inning. Bedard's had 3 shoulder surgeries and said he didn't want to put himself at risk. Understandable. But while pitching a no-hitter, the ERA is 4.6.